always thought the deadline was like public, because the public is going to question. Expect more money than high. Budget comes out in 2 weeks. I don't suppose I can invest or sit on this for 2 weeks.
Such things can be some of this business.
And I can't appeal to the sense of what's in the nation's best interest.
I always thought the truth was in the nation's best interest.
Well, no, it's the bottom. Or like a billion-dollar pool thing. And it's not going to do a different order. Now, if this comet continues on its path around the sun and keeps its present course, sometime on August 16th, roughly a year from now, there's a chance that we might have it. So for the past 8 months, the United States and Russia have been building the largest spaceship ever constructed. It's being built in orbit around the Earth. We call it the Messiah. Right now, a team of American astronauts and one missioner at Cape Canaveral, Florida. In 2 months, they will leave on the shuttle of Atlantis to board the Messiah. This is the crew that will stop the comet.
Jenny Lerner, MSNBC.
Jenny Lerner?
Mr. President, why was this announcement made sooner?
Well, until we knew that the bill arrived and the comet would be accepted, we saw no reason to alarm the planet. Do you have another question, Ms. Lerner?
Yeah. Is there a connection between the comet and the recall of America?
Our fighting man is going to come home because we thought it was prudent to write the most considerable concern is to have it fail. Although I say the hope is only
actually, Mr. President, just one final question. Sorry. MSNBC has learned that Secretary Whitehouse did not leave for the reasons announced by your administration. In fact, isn't it true, sir, that not everyone in your administration is convinced that the Messiah will save us?
Secretary Rittenhouse served this country with full devotion. He resigned for personal reasons. Now, I have a problem with this. All of you. Everyone in this room, everyone listening to my voice, at some point in the next 10 months, all of us can entertain our worst fears and concerns. But I can also promise you this. Life will go on. We will prevent it.
That's the real news. They said it again. Is he talking about you? Yes, is he?
The Russian is brought into the construction phase of this mission and not in
the Jenny, get the door.
Well, we can have the technology to build the ship. We have the other countries are preparing several games along whatever line they are.
detonation succeeded. However, did not destroy the tower. There are now
8.8 earthquake. In our lifetime, we could very well see one of these cities destroyed. We will actually see this happen, perhaps. San Francisco, Los Angeles, Tokyo.
Look, here's the tectonic plate. Is that Tokyo? Today, it's an earthquake. Just today. Okay? Tokyo. Alright? Now look, March 11th is this Friday. Coming into alignment. You want to call it a comet, you want to call it an asteroid, you want to call it a brown dwarf, doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. It's causing effects on the planet. There's going to be another shift in the axis, I'm sure of it. How big it's going to be, I don't know. But it's going to be bigger than the Chile earthquake last year, I'm sure of that. Please just get out of those areas.
Seen this CNN report on comet ELEnin. Nice to see that mainstream news are finally reporting what most of us have been saying on YouTube for some time now. But the main thing I wanted to point out about this news story, I mean, there's a couple of aspects if you read through it, but the main thing is, for a start, they've got all these dates when supposedly aligned and caused earthquakes. Well, there are certainly some alignments in this list are good, but some are very questionable. But the main point I wanted to make is where they say that watch out for the next alignment, which is September the 6th. Supposedly, ELEnin, Mercury, Mars, and then they kind of write Earth after that. It's a strange alignment. They come down to say the next...